हरे कृष्णा, वेलकम
कृष्ण
टू ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन। अनदर सेशन अबाउट श्रीमद् भागवतम 10th कैंटो 13th चैप्टर ऑफ ब्रह्मा सम्मोहन लीला, द बिविल्डरमेंट ऑफ लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा। सो इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्टली, लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड till the time Krishna reached home, after he multiplied himself into all the cowherd boys and all the calves, baby bulls, baby cows, and everybody else who was with him. It is not only that he had cows and calves and cowherd boys, he also had baby buffaloes and rabbits and deers, and everybody was there, all babies. So Krishna converted himself into all those, perfectly matching each and everybody's style of talking, style of dressing, style of putting things, style of working, every single thing, all the habits, you know, playing buffalo horn, playing flute, singing, joking, teasing, all kinds of things exactly multiplied, exactly duplicated. And with this singing and dancing and joking, they all reached home. Now, what happened was, when they reached home, usually when they reach home, what happens? Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj are very eager. It's already sunset time, so they don't want to wait on the top. So they come down in a place called Nanda Baitak. Very famous place on the ground level, on the ground, not on the mountain. And then they are waiting eagerly. So Krishna and Balram and cowherd boys come running. And usually what happens? Usually what happens is all the cowherd boys and Krishna and Balram, all of them are eager to tell what happened that day. So Nanda Maharaj is having Krishna on one lap, Balram on another lap, and he has to just looking here, there, because both the laps, both the children are talking. In between, the other cowherd boys are talking. They want to tell everything from their side, and everybody wants to tell from their side. And it's like chaos created by children. Very loving, pleasant chaos. And then they have to sit there for a long time to hear from everybody. Everybody has their angle of the whole Leela. And they have to satisfy them that they have now emptied all their buckets of their whatever they have to say. And then they will be carried up, and the mothers and fathers of the cowherd boys, they will come, they'll pick their children up, and they will go. And of course, without it goes without saying that everybody will hug their children, embrace their children, you know, smell their head, remove their turbans and smell their foreheads and hair and embrace them, kiss them. So many things they will do while hearing all those things. It's a very, very dynamic, eventful activity. It's not just mechanical, boring activity. It's like a lot of excitement is there when Krishna Balaram come home with cowherd boys. So this day, what happened? Something different has to happen, because now the cowherd boys are not cowherd boys. They're all Krishnas. So everybody, Shukadev Goswami, you know, in the end of the 13th chapter of 10th canto, he explains what kind of love the Brijvasis had for Krishna. Usually, all the mothers and fathers, they love their children the most all over about everybody in the world. I mean, no child can be more lovable than their own child. However ugly looking, however naughty, or however misbehaving, or whatever it is, the love that the parents have for their children is something which is very unique. So in this case, it is not so. In this case, every mother in Vrindavan, every father in Vrindavan loves Krishna more than their own children. And not that they give secondary treatment to their children, but somehow they love Krishna more than their own children. And there's no envy also on Yashoda that, oh, your child is so sweet, my child is not so sweet. It's not like that. It's just natural, you know. But that day, instead of their eyes centered and focused on Krishna as usual, they were all centered and focused on their own children. Because they were Krishna, naturally. And they were like enamored by their own children. And they were not looking at Krishna as intently as they would do otherwise. So the mothers showered their love on them as they shower on Krishna other times. Overflowing with love, they felt unlimited joy while they were interacting with their children. Previously, all the Brijvasi felt more affection for Krishna than their own children, but for this whole year, they displayed ever increasing affection for their own sons. Now, everyone had the amazing, unexplainable, intense happiness while they bathed their children, dressed their children, put new ornaments on their children, put flowers on their children, fed their children, some of them on breast, some of them sweetmeats. But they were amazingly happy, which they also couldn't understand why they're so happy. But one thing was different, which is also a unique thing, that nobody narrated that day what happened that day. Amazingly, there was no story that day. There was no chaos that day. Everybody was just hugging and kissing and embracing their children and enjoying unlimited, unbelievable, inconceivable happiness. But nobody narrated what happened that day. But the love was so overwhelming. And nobody even remembered, Kiare, today they didn't tell some stories. They're also amazing because they're so overwhelming with love. And this is about the children, like the human beings, human children. What about the calves? The calves ran into the cowshed. And the cows were amazingly attracted to their own calves. Usually even cows, they would gaze at Krishna when Krishna would come back. Now, cows are not going now with Krishna. Till now, only baby cows are going with Krishna. So they are envying there in one sense. Like they feel, oh, how fortunate our children are. They go with baby Krishna and they have such wonderful pastimes. So they also would be waiting. But when they would be waiting, they would gaze on Krishna, not on their calves. But today, all the cows were simply looking at their children. They licked them again and again, uncontrollably. Experiencing unlimited ocean of bliss. The cows made deep moving sounds in ecstasy, and unusually they slept and started sleeping with their calves in the night also. Generally they don't sleep with their children. It's not like human culture. But the cows started sleeping with their, they could not just part with their calves, you know. So this was something which is very unique. This happened. Now, one pastime I must tell you, which has happened little before this. What happened little before this? That Brahma came, he saw in the sky, riding on the swan, what's happening at the bank of Jamuna. So beautiful, ecstatic pastimes. He was doubting, but still he felt so much bliss by watching that beautiful, transcendental, blissful pastime of Krishna. So to test that, he stole the calves and the cowherd boys. Ananda Vrindavan Chandu explains that also there are some Brajvasi scriptures. They explain that the cowherd boys were quite awake while Brahma was carrying them. They were hypnotized when they went in the cave of Brahma Loka. But on the way, they were thinking, really teach a good lesson to this Brahma. What does he think of himself? But they thought that if you do any masti there, then Brahma Loka may slip down from Brahma Loka position and come down on earth and go under the earth. Hindi mein kya bolte hain? वो ब्रह्मा लोक अपनी जगह से निकल के पृथ्वी पर धस जाएगा ब्रज भूमि के अंदर So we should not create this kind of chaos. But we will teach him a good lesson in Braj when he will come. Time will come that we are not going to stay permanently in this cave by Brahma's control. We will teach him a good lesson. So they chose to get hypnotized. You know, these people, I can understand by this particular small pastime that they are very powerful people. They may appear to be very naughty, small, innocent children, but they are actually big, big, big yogis and jnanis and sadhakas, perfected sadhakas, siddha sadhakas of previous lifetimes who have won the heart of Krishna and Radharani. And that's why they have taken birth and now they appear to be innocent, you know, uncultured or naughty or not look like very grave sadhakas and sadhus and saintly people. But they are very powerful because they are fully favored by Krishna, fully under the direct favor and protection and love and affection of Krishna. So they're naturally extremely powerful. It's like a personal assistant of a owner of the company is as powerful as the owner because, you know, he has so much power. He can meet the boss anytime. He can just chuck you off or let you in. He has a lot of power. So that kind of power these cowherd boys had. Now, I told you what they are saying now. Ki, okay, we will show him when they come. So when the boys were brought back, this is interesting. I will tell you right now, this only this much that they were telling that we will show Brahma when we'll come down. Okay. I will go further. What happened? Now that night, you know, Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda, they were really so happy. And they bathed Krishna, they dressed up Krishna and Balaram. Balaram was not there. Balaram was not there in the team. So Krishna came back and he bathed him nicely. She fed him and breast milk and also sweetmeats and sang songs and went to sleep. Next morning, all the Krishnas in the different houses, they woke up and the mothers and they felt great joy in dressing and bathing their children and never other times, they felt so much bliss. It was so blissful. And they all accompanied their children to the house of Nanda Maharaj. And Nanda Maharaj also, Yashoda Mai, dressed up Krishna. And that day, Balaram also, because Balaram now, yesterday birthday is over. Nah? So today is also with them. So they all are getting ready. And Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mai, and amazingly, all the mothers of cowherd boys, they are not able to leave their children. They're just walking with them. And they're requesting their children, please allow us to come with you till the edge of the forest. So everybody, mother and father, they walked all the way till the beginning of the forest that they're going to enter. And where did they go? They chose to go to Govardhan that day. So in the Govardhan area, you know, there is a beginning of Govardhan area. Even today also, when we go from Barsana to Govardhan, Nandagaon to Govardhan, different ways are there. In those days, there are different ways also were there. So they walked long distance. And then finally, they had to stand there and keep gazing, till Krishna and cowherd boys disappeared. And the cows were not able to leave their calves. And you know, one thing amazing happened. Like, you know, the cow gives birth to a calf. And at a certain time, she keeps feeding milk. And then at one point of time, the calf leaves the cow. I mean, no more milk is required. He's independent. And the cow becomes pregnant and gives birth to another baby. And sometimes she's pregnant and sometimes she's having another baby, small baby, you know, licking and all things. So these calves at this point of time were the calves which already had left their mother. They are no more going to their mother for drinking milk. But still, they ran to the cows and the cows were licking them as if they are newborn children while they already had another newborn children. They had many more newborn calves, but they are still showing extraordinary affection to these cows. So now what's happening in the sea? Krishna has gone with his calves, baby cows and baby bulls with Balaramji to Govardhan. And cowherd men who are big cowherd men, you know, men, father and father type, they are also grazing their cows. And they also happened to go without knowledge to Govardhan only. but the baby cows are grazing at the bottom of the mountain and the big cows are grazing on the top of the mountain. And when they are grazing on top of the mountain, suddenly Krishna enters Govardhan area. And lo and behold, what happened? The baby cows are, you know, what they are doing? They are grazing down. And suddenly the big cows saw these cows, these baby cows. And amazingly, everything was so peaceful. You know, when the cows are grazing, you see, sometimes we are passing by Lonavala train, we see cows grazing in the greenery and then they are so peaceful. There's no speed. It's just like one step, two steps, grazing, engrossed and they go ahead and all. Suddenly they started running and that too downhill and that too with the speed of the wind. They were not, you know, only the four hooves were touching the ground sometimes in between, but they were just like, hopping with their two and two hind and front legs. And the coward boys, who were taking care of them, they were just had difficult time running behind them to control them. But they were thinking they will tumble down. They'll break their bones. They will hurt themselves. But they were so fast that he said that the coward men were running behind them like crazy. And it is also explained that their legs started paining when they ran so much fast behind. But they were unable to control these big cows. I know big cows are big. And they're not like today's big cows. They were Nanda Maharaj's big cows. You can imagine they were so big, their udders were always touching the ground. Maybe, I don't know whether how many, 30, 80, 40 liters they were milk they were giving, maybe unlimited milk they were giving. So big cows. They all started running with speed. And these calves, which were with coward boys who were Krishna themselves, they left them and started running also fast. And after that, the men also had another scenario. First, they were running to control the cows and suddenly the men saw their children. So, as soon as they saw their children, their leg pains disappeared and they started uncontrollably showering love on these coward boys, kissing them. They removed their turbans, started smelling their hair, kissing them on forehead, kissing them on cheeks, embracing them and shedding the front part of the cloths of the coward men were wet with their tears, and back part of the cloths of the coward boys were getting back, and the cloth and the upper cloth were getting wet with their tears, and they just couldn't control themselves. And the cows are licking the calves and the men are licking the boys, loving. And Krishna Balaram watching. And Krishna knows everything, but Balaram is watching. Balaram is thinking, I'll tell you what Balaram is thinking. Balaram was very happy to see the intense love shared between the cows and the calves and felt doubtful about it since the calves had already grown up and stopped sucking milk from their mothers. So he pondered, alas, aha, how astonishing. My affection and that of all the Brajvasis towards these boys and calves is increasing every day like never before. I am also feeling so much of love for these calves and these coward boys. Although I love them, but my love is increasing unbelievably. It perfectly resembles love that we all feel for Krishna. I can see the coward men, the love that they feel for Krishna is expressed when they are meeting their sons, and the love the cows feel for their cows, for Krishna, they are expressing it for their cows. So something unusual is happening here. The super soul in every living entity is Krishna, and the love that they feel for Krishna is being expressed here. This must be a display of Lord's inconceivable energy, Achintya Shakti. Otherwise, how could I, the elder brother of Chakrapani, Sri Krishna, who destroys all illusory energy, how can I be bewildered by some mystical play like this? Therefore, I will inquire from Krishna, from the crushed jewel of all mystics, crushed jewel of all the Siddhas, I will inquire. So Balaram said, Krishna, I'm amazed. I have faith that you possess superior intelligence beyond my comprehension. Now I can see that you alone have manifested yourself in different forms as these calves and these cowherd boys, they are none other than your expansions, your personal expansions as four-armed Narayan forms. Please tell me why you have done this. So, we are reading in 1 minute, but Balaramji was thinking for a long time, observing intently all these things and meditating why this must be like this. He was observing everybody's emotion very closely and then concluding. And then also he was bewildered for some time, wondering, how can I be bewildered? Is it that Krishna is putting his spell of Maya, or what is the reality? So first also he inquired and he put his doubt. Is that true that all these people are you? In that case, then if all these people are you, then where are the original boys and calves? So then Krishna, in seclusion, when all this Leela was going on, Krishna took Balaram aside and privately told him all the story in brief, what exactly happened. So then Balaram came to know, now why all this happening, he understood why it is happening. After some time, the coward men were satisfied expressing their love for the boys, and they left their boys. But they had great difficulty in separating the cows from their calves. The cows were not living only. So with great difficulty, they had to separate. Even the coward boys also helped the calves to be separated from their cows. And that day, it seems the cows did not eat any grass only. They were so satisfied. They stopped grazing. They were so much in bliss. They just were taken back home. Now, after waiting for a moment, now I'll tell you few more things that happened. This is the pastime that happened. It's given in Bhagavatam also and in the other scriptures also. Then what happened? Now you know the story that which I narrated, I think, to you some times ago in the Yatra, online Yatra, that there was a Pili Pukar pastime and Yashoda Devi, got overwhelmed one day and she put turmeric powder and did something like unplanned sagai for Radharani. And everybody is so happy. All the Brajvasis came to know. By that logical transcendental conclusion, yes, Yashoda Mai has done the engagement of Radharani with Krishna. So happy to know that. They went and announced themselves. Yes, yes. Vrishabhanu Maharaj, Kirti Mataji, we came to know that you have engaged your daughter with the son of Nanda and Yashoda. Let us celebrate. They were not knowing. They were shocked, lovingly, happily shocked. And they looked at Radharani. Radharani also put his hard head down and kind of accepted what happened was true. And she had washed her hands in the pond and the pond had become yellow. And by this, Vrishabhanu Maharaj sent gift in acceptance of the unplanned activity that Yashoda Mataji did. That, okay, we approve this. They also multiplied, Krishna multiplied the pearls by sowing the pearls in the ground, and that was sent back. And then when this exchange took place, officially the coward boys and women, men and women, went to Purnamasi to take out a muhurta for the wedding of Radha and Krishna. Such an auspicious thing has happened unknowingly and unplanned. Let us give a very formal form to the one, formal roof for that. So they went to Purnamasi for taking out Murtha, and Purnamasi was very smart. Purnamasi knew, because she is also Parvati Devi. She is also the external energy of Krishna. She is assisting Krishna. So she knows all the internal secrets of Krishna's pastime. In fact, they are happening through her agency. So she understood that it's too premature a time to end the Parakya Ras Leela and start Swakya Leela. It is still time. Krishna and Radharani and Gopis, they have to still enjoy that, hiding and sending messages through birds, and sometimes Radharani becoming cuckoo and Krishna become male cuckoo bird, and so many things, Kokila one and Sanket one, and so many showing signals from Barsana, and Krishna showing signals from Nandagaon top. All this hiding and meeting and having private meetings and secret meetings and all this called as Parakya Ras. So she didn't want to end the Parakya Ras because Krishna also and the desire to enjoy Parakya Ras more. So keeping this internal reason intact, she said that the constellation of the stars in the sky is not favorable for wedding. We should wait for the auspicious constellation. Akash mein nakshatra bhi sahi jagah par nahi. When they will form the auspicious combination, that time we will get them married. So she somehow very nicely postponed the concept of their wedding. It's like, you know, even then some boys and girls are getting matched, for example. And then for some reason they don't like and they want to just say, no, what they'll say? Ki horoscope match nahi ho raha hai. The charts are not matching. Even though they are matching from one side, the other side will say, no, our Pandit says it doesn't match. So that's like a gentleman's way to say no. So this is a gentleman's way to say no for the marriage of Radha and Krishna. So that time, Radha and Gopis, all of them got very upset. Because although everybody was proposing for Radharani to get married with Krishna, but every other Gopi also was interested in marrying with Krishna. They all were desiring, without any envy for each other, desiring Krishna to be their husband. So all of them, they got little morose. So when Kartik ended, all of them performed Katyayani Vrat at the banks of Yamuna. Under the guidance of Yamuna Devi and under the guidance of also Purnamasi and elderly gopis, they decided to go and they were described the Vrata, Katyayani Vrata. They went to and formed the deity of sand for making Katyayani Devi out of sand. And then they worshipped for 30 days. As it was growing winter, they were becoming very, very shivering cold and they had to submerge themselves in the water and chant mantras and fast whole day, chant mantras and songs in pleasure of Krishna, only take Havishya without salt and spices and sugar in the evening and then come home and again go early morning at first prahar of the day. So what they were desiring? To Katyayani Devi, that let Krishna be our husband. So all of them were desiring that. So Krishna knew that. So why did Krishna duplicate himself into all the coward boys? Because he knew that he had to sometime fulfill the desire of all these gopis. One reason. Second reason, all the mother gopis, they were always desiring that we love our children. We love Sri Dama, we love Madhu Mangal, but we love Krishna more than our children and we wanted, someday Krishna becomes my child. I'll have the fortune of having Krishna as my child. I can put him on my breast. I can suck, embrace him. I can bathe him. Wow, what a fortune. So all the mothers wanted to have Krishna as their children. And all the cows, because, in Vrindavan, all the cows talk human language, birds talk human language, everybody talks human language. So all of them were also desiring to have Krishna as their child. So in one stroke, Krishna satisfied every cow by becoming the calf. And for one full year, Krishna lived as a calf for each cow. And again, I repeat that they were not the milk drinking calves. They already had grown up. So these mothers were feeding the baby infant cows, baby cows. And also they were feeding these big cows also who had given up drinking milk from their mothers. Similarly, the boys were not so small. They also had grown up. They had also given up breast milk, drinking breast milk from their mother. But all the mothers were giving breast milk to them also. It's like, you have 5-year-old son, 6-year-old son, still coming from school and drinking your milk. So they were also doing the same thing. They were coming from herding cows and again drinking mother's milk. And, they were dressing them like babies and ornamenting and all the beautiful things. For one full year, everybody enjoyed having Krishna as their children in the form of cows, in the form of cowherd boys. Remaining were the girls. So then Krishna went to his father during this year and said, Baba, it's a very auspicious time. It's the right time to get all the gopis married with all the gopas. So all the gopis who are marriageable age, all of them, were coupled, were paired and they were married. So in that whole coupling, the one question always comes, why did Krishna not marry? Krishna also could have got married with one gopi, na? But Krishna actually married all the gopis in the forms of all the gopas. But Krishna Balaram did not get married in Vrindavan Dham, personally. So Radharani got married with Abhimanyu. In the whole, matchmaking, Radharani was matched with Abhimanyu, the son of Jatila and the brother of Kutila. Chandravali got married with Govardhan Malla. And like that, all of them were matched with all the gopas. And they entered in the houses of all the cowherd boys. And they stayed 1 year as their wives in their house. And Krishna personally was interacting with them in the form of that particular gopa. That means Abhimanyu was Krishna. And he was enjoying conjugal pastimes with Radharani at Javat. So one whole year, Krishna gave pleasure to all the gopis who wanted to marry with Krishna. He gave them the position of the wife and they all stayed with him. They enjoyed with him officially. And Krishna also was watching everybody, enjoying with all the gopis, all the cowherd boys. And it was such a fantastic scene that very uniquely happened throughout the year. Now the question comes, what happened after the original cowherd boys came back? You know, our children, when I take children classes Monday and Tuesday, children are so smart and so analytical. They said, how did the transition take place? When the Krishna wala cowherd boy disappeared and the real cowherd boy came back. So he did not know, this is my wife. So who informed them about all these things and their next role, what is the next role to play? Very difficult question, you know. So the possible answer is that Krishna inspired this information in the heart of all the gopas, that it was me who stayed with all these gopis as husband for one full year. And now you are going to come as their husband. But your role is not to enjoy them, but to create a parakya ras with me, amongst me and them. They will constantly like to meet me and they will and you will try to oppose them every time. So you can see when Radharani was with Abhimanyu, she was not hankering to go and meet Krishna. Because she was already meeting Krishna in the form of Abhimanyu, right? But when Abhimanyu actually came back and Krishna withdrew all his forms, their center of attraction turned to the actual Krishna. And the hankering and the feeling of separation and the pain of not being with him all started. So 1 year of union and then so many years of separation again. That is a unique situation which happened during the 1 year of Brahma Samohan Leela. So this is the Leela which happened of wedding of Krishna with all the gopis. So Krishna fulfilled the desire of each and every Brijvasi. Every single Brijvasi was elderly, had the affection of to Krishna as a child, they were fulfilled. All the older cows, they got fulfilled with their desire of Krishna, having Krishna as their child. All the young marriageable gopis got married with Krishna. So Krishna actually satisfied everybody in the whole Braj Bhumi. And how did he behave as cows? Please listen carefully. We hear Brahmanda Leela and where Krishna ate dirt. Kana ne mati khai. So it's a pastime. Krishna ate dirt and there was a big pastime and we described the story, how they complained and everything. But that happened only once, that Krishna ate dirt. But Krishna loves Braj Raj so much that in the form of calves, when he became cows, he ate the dirt of every square inch of whole Braj Bhumi. Because 1 year they went to get herd, cow herding. They went everywhere in Braj. They covered all the Braj. And while eating the grass, Krishna as a calf, also ate dirt in every single place. So every inch of Braj Bhumi, Krishna has eaten the dirt. Each and every item, every atom, every square millimeter of Braj Bhumi, is licked by Krishna when he was a baby calf. And not one day, for one full year, Krishna was licking the dust of Vrindavan. Because that dust is traversed by all the cowherd boys, all the cowherd girls, gopis, and all the great devotees who are Brajbasis. They are traversing on that dust. So Krishna wants to eat that dust to express his love and appreciation and honor his great devotees who live in Vrindavan Dham. So after all that, 1 year, and one more thing is there. It is explained that the demigods were coming in between to see the fun. Oh, just see, the mothers must be crying. Where is our babies? The cows must be crying. Where are our cows? But all are hiding in Brahma Loka. It is also explained in some book that Brahma also came in between to see the fun, because he wanted to see the fun, And what he was seeing, nobody was crying and no cow was crying. Instead, all the places, there were all music going on of marriages. Everywhere there were marriages. Full Braj Bhumi was filled with marriages from top to bottom, south to north, east to west. Every forest, every loka, wherever there were Brajvasis, they were all getting married. So wherever Brahmaji went to see, there were all marriage ceremonies going on. All sweetmeats, dancing, music, nice dresses, colorful dresses, flowers, ornaments everywhere. So he said, where is the sorrow here? There's no sorrow. There's so much of joy. Everywhere, everybody is present. Where are the children? They all are there. Who are the children with me? So it seems, one book it is explained that, Bhagavatam explains that he came back in one moment. Right? He came back in one moment. And his one moment was 1 year of Prithvi, of the earth. And that's all. That is where the Leela manifested further, multiplied, and Leela ended. But also, as Kalpa Bheda, it is explained that Brahma came to see the fun, what he has created, and see the sorrow of all these Vrindavasis, but he saw all the happinesses, so he was bewildered more. He went back to Brahmaloka to check whether these children are very mysterious or what. Are these children themselves mystics? Then they disappear, they appear to be sleeping there, they come down here and they display pastime and again they go down to sleep. So he went there and he saw everybody is sleeping. So he said, okay, he confirmed that all these people are there. I have confirmed that they are there under my spell of hypnotism. They are sleeping there. And he comes down and again he sees all the marriages and all happiness and cow herding and jumping and dancing, everybody kissing, hugging, embracing. So he's like, again he goes back. Again he sees everybody sleeping there beautifully. Each and every calf, each and every cowherd boy is sleeping there, and each and every calf and cowherd boy is also playing there in Vrindavan Dham. So I think he explained that he went up and down many times. And then finally, he was tired. Sometimes, if you are given some puzzle, if you solve it in 5 minutes, you are so happy and blissful. I solved it. But suppose it takes 2 days and you just couldn't solve it, you get frustrated, Where's the happiness? There's no happiness. So Brahma, by doing this study, he was so bewildered. Now I'll tell you, there's another interesting thing which to know. How we can understand that these were actual pastimes that took place that time. I'll tell you 7 places or 8 places. Okay. First place is called as Pasoli, which is the apabhramsha or distortion of the world, Sarpasthali, which is also known as Ajayvan, as I told you last time, which is also called as Jayat, right? That is a place where Agasur, gulped Krishna and all the coward boys. That is where Kaliya afterwards went and took rest. Then same place is also called as Jayat, I told you, because all the Devatas and Brajvasis, they did Jai Jaikar, Jayati, 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 which Brahma also heard in Brahmaloka, which brought him down. So that is another place called Jayat, same place. There's one nearby place called Bajna. In that Bajna place, it's still there today also. The demigods, they played their instruments, drums, dundubis, and bheris, and big things they played there in enjoyment of Krishna's killing Agasura. Next place is called Parkham. Now, all this is one area, but the area is so huge that a part of the area is called Parkham. And the Parkham is a place where Brahmaji thought of testing Krishna. Pariksha. Parkham means Pariksha. Pariksha lene ka vichar kiya ki inka Pariksha lenge. So there is another place called Vatsavan, which we had gone with our advance party, and I took all the brahmacharis there, and we had very good time. It was raining very heavily and very beautiful, lonely place, very esoteric, peaceful place, Jamunaji flowing. That is called Vatsavan. The Brajvasis call it as Bachpan. Kaha jana hai aapko? Bachpan jana hai, Bachpan. And they will call Krishna as Bachpan Bihari. What is Bachpan? Vatsavan. Vatsavan Bihari. So at Vatsavan, Brahmaji stole all the calves, baby cows and baby bulls. Then there's a place called Balhara. You must be knowing what is the meaning of Balhara. All the boys were stolen from that place. Because cows, the baby cows had moved some distance in the alluring, in the temptation of the cows, of the grass. They had gone a little away from the assembly of the cowherd boys. That means Balhara was the place of assembly of the cowherd boys, where they were sitting in a lotus design. And the calves had gone away at the banks of Jamuna. So that is called as Vatsavan. And Balhara is the place where they sat down on the banks of Jamuna. Then afterwards, now we are at the situation of the Katha. Now Brahma has come back completely exhausted. His four brains are fully exhausted. They are tired. They lost their dopamine and serotonin, all the wonderful chemicals which give you energy in the brain. They are all like depleted, completely exhausted and frustrated. And he has come to a place called Sei. Now, I'll tell you now what happened at Sei before I declare to you what Sei was. So, Brahma has come back now. And what is he watching? The children are at the same place from where he has stolen them. The baby cows are there nicely, you know, grazing in the fresh green grass and having nice time. There's no worry, distress or tension in them. Krishna is as much as before, you know, having that, what I told you last time, right hand achar. In between the fingers, the fruits were hanging. Left hand, the mixture of rice and yogurt, and again fruits were hanging. And he was eating in between and also going out and searching. His right side, there was a flute tucked on the waist, and left side there was a bugle, buffalo horn, and the cow herding stick, lakuti. And there was Kamar Kachani, and there were so many descriptions I did last time to you. More Pankha and Kaustubh Mani and Srivastha Chinna, all those beautiful things are there. And Krishna is still looking so beautiful, exchanging beautiful things and eating and feeding. As I told you, Subal was feeding and Madhu Mangal was feeding, and Krishna said, oh, I can't do the testing because I don't have the understanding of taste. And what did the cowherd boy say that time? Cowherd boy said, one whose maternal grandfather is a fool number one, he does not have the taste of foods. So all these things are going on as it is. And Brahmaji is so bewildered. My God, how this can happen? I'm so powerful. I'm such a mystic. I have such an illusory power. I hypnotize. I kidnapped them. Are the same boys here or different boys are here? And that made him go up and down. Okay. And finally, when he came, finally exhausted, suddenly all the calves and all the cowherd boys, there were millions of them, all of them turned into Vishnus. Each one became Vishnu. Okay. Now that Bhagavatam is not explaining in great details everything, because I again tell you that Shukadeva Maharaj didn't have much time to go on all these detailed analytical pastimes. So Bhagavatam says that, okay, Krishna became Vishnus, and then immediately Krishna withdrew his forms and Brahma surrendered. But actually what happened, I'll tell you. All these cowherd boys were 400 Vishnu forms, fully decorated with priceless ornaments, holding four symbols of Shankha Chakra Padma Gada. These forms were embodied unlimited bliss and knowledge, and their combined effulgences surpassed the light of millions of suns and moons. Please hear the description and visualize in front of your eyes what must be happening there. Their bodily hair stood erect in ecstasy, and the perspiration coming from their bodies resembled globe-like universes rising from the pores of Lord Vishnu. That means each Vishnu was pouring out universes from each pore of his body. And there were millions and trillions of such cowherd boys and the cows. Even the cows became Vishnus. Please understand. All these Vishnu forms were bluish with yellow silken garments. It glowed like lightning. They were bedecked with jewels, earrings, crowns, necklaces, armlets. Glittering golden bangles were jingled very sweetly. They were not standing like a statue. They were quite mobile and active. So their bangles were jingling. Swarms of buzzing bees hovered around their fresh, tender tulsi garlands around their necks, which were going all the way till their thighs. And then the tiny tinkling bells suspended from their golden belts emitted delicate, enlightening, enticing sounds. Now this is the first scene. What is the second scene? Listen, oh dear devotees, what is the second scene? Each Vishnu form had a set of 33 crores of demigods worshipping them, devarishis singing songs, and demigods offering gift items to them, offering them worship and praises and singing songs. You can imagine how much chaos must be there. Each Vishnu form had 33 crores demigods worshipping. That means each form had one Devi, each form had one Brahma, each form had one Shiva, one Vayu, one Indra, and other subordinate demigods, and all of them, Gandharvas, Apsaras, everything was there. And he said that beyond that, each Vishnu exhibited Virat Rupa. Can you imagine that? One Virat Rupa Arjuna could not tolerate. And there were so many Virat Rupas. What Brahma saw, listen carefully, Brahma saw the space, the time factor, the three gunas, the five elements, the seasons, the eight mystic perfections, Prapti Siddhi, Anima, Mahima, Lagima, nine planets, 10 directions, the presiding deities of all the senses, the 14 Manus, and all the other aspects of material creation had been subjugated by the potency of the Lord. And one Brahma of four heads is watching all these things. That means he is watching unlimited Brahmas in the sets of all the demigods. Because in the sets of demigods, everywhere Shiva is Panchanana. But everywhere Brahma is not Chaturmukha. Somewhere is 10 Mukha, 100 Mukha, 1000 Mukha, 10,000, 1 lakh, 10 lakhs, 1 crore, 10 crores, hundreds of crores heads were there. So each Brahma was different. And this four-headed Brahma is watching all this scenario of various Brahmas in various Vishnu forms, worshipping the Supreme Lord. And although everybody was offering prayers, there was no chaotic feelings for his ears. It's all so sweet and pleasant, although there were so many people singing praises of all Vishnu forms. So one can perceive. So all this truth can be perceived by only by the mercy of the Lord. Please understand, this reality is exposed to Brahma. It is not that Brahma had some qualification. Krishna, out of his kindness, was revealing in the truth, because being the supreme creator of the universe, the first citizen of the creator of the universe. Then what happened? Then Krishna removed all the Vishnu forms. All of a sudden, Brahma is fully bewildered now. He doesn't know what is the truth, what is false, what I'm watching is truth or not. He's completely getting mad. And to add in his illusory feelings, Krishna withdrew at once all the Vishnu forms. And now there were no coward boys, no Vishnu forms, only Krishna appearing to be bewildered, having achar and mixture of yogurt and rice and fruits in his hands, and searching for his coward boys and searching for his calves. Innocently looking for them with so much bewilderment on his face. At that time, Brahma realized that he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Now, one point all of you should know. when Brahma came to Vrindavan, he did not see actual Vrindavan because he was in a testing mood. The real darshan of Vrindavan was not revealed, although he was in Vrindavan. So similarly, if our consciousness is not right, we may go to Vrindavan, but that real Vrindavan will not be revealed to you. You only will see kichad and, you know, pigs and cheating rickshawalas and cheating pandas and cheating snatching monkeys and everything. That only you will see, and you will keep either be happy or unhappy with the external situation. So when did Brahma see the real Vrindavan? Only when he realized his mistake and he started repenting. And when he repented, actually it is said that he had worn 4 dazzling crowns on his foreheads, and it had such jewels that each jewel was more effulgent than hundreds of moons and suns. Now this is not description about Krishna's crown, this is description of Brahma's crown. So Brahma, it is said that he bowed down with all his 4 crowns with dazzling jewels on that, and they were, all the 4 crowns were rushing to touch the lotus feet of Krishna. And it is said that Brahma bowed down with his 4 crowns again and again and again to the lotus feet of Krishna. Then finally his 8 eyes poured so much of tears that Krishna, his feet were bathed by Brahma's repentful tears. And Brahma was saying, what a fool number one I am, that I did such kind of foolish mistake. I tested my Lord. So I told you a Sei, the place Sei, the 6th place, the 7th place called Sei. So in the Hindi they say, ye wahi hai, ye wahi hai, ye wahi hai. Brahma got the realization ki, oh, he's the same personality, supreme personality of Godhead. He realized at the place called Sei. You know where Sei is? From our ISKCON temple, when you go to Chatikra, we go to a temple called Garud Govinda, where Sridhama became Garuda and Krishna became 12-armed Vishnu. So from that place, you go further down for a few kilometers, you will come to a sandy beach of Yamuna, even today. And that sand is so soft like talcum powder, even today also. So that is the place Brahma saw these Vishnu forms, all the Vishnu forms, unlimited one. He was observing. And that time, till that time, he was on swan only. But when he saw those Vishnu forms, he came down on the swan, got down the swan. And then when Krishna made the all forms disappear, he bowed down and cried tears of repentance. It is said that time, Krishna, who was like looking innocent boy having rice and achar in his hand, that time cows manifested behind him. Kalpavrikshas manifested behind him. Peacocks appeared behind him. Govardhan mountain appeared behind him. Yamuna came in front and started flowing. So all the real glory of Vrindavan with Kalpavriksha trees, with all the beautiful inhabitants of Vrindavan, all the beautiful sounds, and the real glory of Vrindavan was manifested to the eyes of Brahma and not before that. So what do you need to see real Vrindavan? Is the heart and the consciousness with love and devotion for Krishna. That is when premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena, when heart and eyes are tinged with the ointment of love, at that time you see things as they are. It is not that he's creating something there. Things are already there, but they're unmanifest to the mortal eye. And they become visible to the mortal eye when the devotion of and love manifests in the heart of a devotee. So that is the time when Brahma saw the real Vrindavan manifest in front of his eyes. Now I'll tell you what further happened. There's something called as Braj Bhagavat, which is told by Shandilya Muni to Vajranab, Krishna's great grandson. In that it is mentioned that Krishna did not forgive Brahma even after he shed tears and bathed his lotus feet, even after he, you know, praised him and did express his repentance. Krishna did not forgive him. So then what happened afterwards? Krishna indicated him, you go and do Dandavati Parikrama of Brajbhumi. So first Brahma offered prostrated Dandavat Pranam to Sri Krishna himself. And then he did Dandavati Parikrama, taking shelter of the dust of Brajbhumi and the Brajbhumi itself, all over 84 proshas of Brajbhumi. And it is said that his body is fully white, like clouds of spring, like snow. His body is so effulgent and white. He is so fair looking. But because of this offense of testing Krishna, he had turned black. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu turned black when Jagai Madhai, their sins he took over. You know, his effulgent golden body became nistej, lost its luster and became black. So like that, Brahmaji's body had become black. So as Brahma started performing Dandavati Parikrama, he started gaining his luster again. So it is explained in one of the Brijvasi stories that when Brahma was in between doing Parikrama of Govardhan, because Brajmandal Parikrama, Dandavati, includes Govardhan Parikrama also. So somewhere he was coming by the side of Govardhan, and many Brijvasis also were performing Govardhan Parikrama at that time. So they asked, "Arey, Brahmaji, what happened? Why have you turned black?" He was so sorry. He said, "I am such a rascal. I did so many offenses. So I have to do this repentful activity." So as he was progressing towards completion of his Brajmandal Parikrama Dandavati, he was gaining his color back again. And by the time he completed his Braj Dandavati Parikrama and he came back to Krishna and offered his final Dandavat, he had regained his full effulgence of the body. That means Krishna may not forgive you if you express your repentance to him personally. You have to take shelter of one of the four things that he has expanded him into. What are the four things? Nama, Rupa, Leela and Dham. They are non-different from Krishna, but at the same time, they are more merciful than Krishna himself, although they are non-different from Krishna. So when Brahma took shelter of one of these four things, that is Dham, and when he did Dham Seva, by performing Parikrama, that time he was forgiven by Krishna. The real forgiveness came when he surrendered or expressed his repentance to Krishna himself, but when he expressed his repentance in the form of Dandavati Parikrama to the Dham of the Lord. So it is said that Dham Seva is higher than Krishna Seva. Nam Seva is higher than Krishna Seva personally. Leela Smaranam, Leela Shravanam is higher than serving Krishna personally. So this is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. Simultaneously, oneness and difference is there. So then Brahma came and Brahma started offering prayers. First of repentance, then of glorification. So next time we will dwell into the ocean of beautiful prayers of Lord Brahma. And what all things he spoke, some important things we'll pick up, because Brahma's prayers, if you start taking details, all the 35-40 lectures will go in their prayers only. But we will take the essence out of it. The same many important prayers we'll pick up and next time we'll discuss. Because why we are discussing the prayers? Not to get bored, but to enter into the pristine, pure consciousness of Brahma. That is why we want to discuss the prayers, because we want to share the mood of Brahma, that pure devotional mood that Brahma exhibited in front of Krishna. After doing a mistake, how one should correct himself, how one should purify himself. Brahma is not a person in Maya actually. Brahma is chosen by Krishna as a topmost personality in the whole universe. He's the topmost personality. Every single thing is topmost in him after Krishna. But even he can commit a mistake. And how does he rectify himself? To set an example, Krishna put him in illusion. To exhibit for ourselves how one should rectify and repent. How one should repent. Okay. So we'll discuss about the prayers next time. And be prepared to allow yourself to enter in the consciousness of Brahma, which is exhibited in the form of those prayers which Shukadeva Maharaj is repeating in front of Parikshit Maharaj in the narration of Srimad Bhagavatam in the form of Vatsapal Leela. This is the Vatsapal last Leela that took place as Vatsapal. Because at this time, Krishna was 5 years old. And when these this lila took place, this took place after 1 year. That means Brahma is offering prayers exactly after 1 year when next birthday of Balram came. And Krishna already become 6 years. So he has entered Pagwanda Avastha. So now he will become Gopal. Immediately after Brahma Samoon Leela, in coming Gopashtami, Kartik Ashtami, Krishna became Gopal. So that is the last pastime that has taken place in Vatsapal Leela. So the transition is going to take place now very soon. From Vatsapal, Krishna is going to become Gopal and he'll start doing not Vastacharan, but Gaucharan he will start doing. Gaucharan Leela will start. So Hare Krishna and thank you very much. Jai. Is there any questions you can ask, please?
Thank you very much, Prabhuji, for making us understand the way we can see Vrindavan.
Oh.
Otherwise, we all go and all we see are the some of the shortcomings.
Good hotels, tikki, lassi, and Lohi Bazaar, and so many things are there which are attracting and diverting our attention from the real Vrindavan.
Yes, Prabhuji. Yes, Prabhuji. Thank you very much. Anybody has any questions?
Yes, anybody has any question?
I think yes. Everybody is still immersed in... Did anybody speak?
Tell you, when I speak this thing to children, they come up with at least 25 questions. And all are bewildering questions. Who told them? And how did this happen? How did that happen? Because they are very chikitsak pravruti. The devotee children have chikitsak pravruti. They will not just hear, they will process everything in the brain when you are talking. And as soon as I end, they just shoot questions like anything. Most unbelievable, unexpected questions. Anyways, so thank you very much.
Thank you.
We will meet next Monday with part 3 of Brahma Samoon Leela. A lot of learning lessons in that. But the real thing which I want to tell you at the last word before I leave, that the real Vrindavan is hidden in the hearts of pure devotees who stay in Vrindavan. And only when you go to Vrindavan and sit at the lotus feet of these devotees and hear them, listen to them, then the treasure of Vrindavan from their heart is revealed in front of the eyes of all of us through the submissive oral reception, the real Vrindavan will be revealed. Even if you go to visit a place, still you will not see real Vrindavan. But when you hear them attentively and submissively, the real glory of Vrindavan will be manifesting from their heart to your heart. And then you will get real immersed into the nectar of Braj Leela. So thank you very much. Vancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindubhya evacha patitanam pavanebhyo वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्री कृष्ण भगवान की जय श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय हो।